Welcome back, Algebra 2. So let's go ahead and talk about the factor theorem. And the factor theorem essentially says x minus r is a factor of a polynomial, p of x, if and only if p of r equals 0. So essentially, when you find what r is, so r is your solution, if you plug it back in, you should get it equaling 0. So I actually want to do a little example here for you of the example we just did. So I'm going to go pull that polynomial, which was v of x equals 4x cubed minus 88x squared plus 480x. So let's actually take that. So v of x equals 4x cubed minus 88x squared plus 480x. And then we're going to take one of these solutions, because it says that one of these should be solutions. So I'm going to use 10, because 10 is probably going to be easy. 0 is a little too easy, because obviously that'll make this whole thing 0. So that one checks out. Well, let's actually do v of 10, and we should get this side equaling 0, like the factor theorem says. So let's plug 10 in. So we get 4 times 10 cubed minus 88 times 10 squared plus 480 times 10. So let's actually figure out what that is. So 4 times, now 10 cubed is going to be 1,000 minus 88. Now 10 squared is 100. Plus 480 times 10 is going to be 4,800. Okay, so that's what that is. And then 4 times 1,000 is 4,000. Minus 88 times 100 is 8,800. Plus 4,800. Now, 4,000 plus 4,800 is 8,800, so then when we subtract 8,800 off, we are going to get 0. So indeed, v of 10 equals 0, therefore 10 is a factor, or rather, 10 is a solution. The factor then would be x minus 10, because that would be r, is a factor of that polynomial, which if we go back, it is a factor of that polynomial. X minus 10 we found to factor in, so that does check out. So as long as 12 works and 0 works, then we can say, all right, well, I can actually build the equation back together. If you have the solutions, so let's just say we had two solutions, 5 and negative 2, then you could build your factors. So if those are solutions, then x minus 5 is a factor, and then x minus a negative 2, which would be x minus a negative, would be a positive 2, then those are factors of your polynomial. And then you can actually take it a step further and FOIL it out. You'd have x squared plus 2x minus 5x is a minus 3x, and then this would be a negative 10 equals 0. So you can actually build your polynomial from the solution. So you can go backwards, and that's what the factor theorem allows us to do. It's pretty cool. Example 2 says find the zeros of p of x equals x to the 4th minus x cubed minus 20x squared by factoring. So let's go ahead and do that. P of x equals x to the 4th power minus x cubed minus 20x squared. So essentially the first step in doing this is to get rid of that p of x equals, and we actually want to set this thing equal to 0. And you can put 0 in the front or the back. I like it in the back, so that's where I'm going to put it. So you set it equal to 0, and then we need to factor this side. So first thing, we start with GCF. Is there a GCF? Well, not a number GCF, but they all have x's, so we can take out an x squared. So that leaves us with x squared minus x minus 20 equals 0. Always check, can I factor more? We did the GCF already, so 2 special patterns. No, because the square root of 20 is not special. 3, guess and check. So guess and check. All right, let's make 2 binomials out of this thing. We know we need x there and x there. Factors of 20 that have a difference of, yikes, there's really a 1 here. So factors of 20 that have a difference of 1, well, that would be 5 and 4. Since I have a negative here, I need alternating signs. And then, so I need a negative. So that means my bigger thing is probably going to need to be negative here. So let's set that up. Let's FOIL this back out just to check. So x times x is x squared. X times a positive 4 is 4x minus 5x. Yep, that does give us negative 1x. And then negative 5 times a positive 4 gives us negative 20. So we factored correctly. So they want us to find the zeros. So zeros, when they use the word zeros, they mean solutions. They might use the word root or roots or even x-intercepts. which we're going to see when we graph here in a bit. So these four words, zero, solutions, roots, and x-intercepts, are synonyms for one another. So anytime you see that, it means basically to find your answer. Okay? So now we have three different things that we actually can get solutions from. I'm going to jump down here and actually write out what our solutions are, because we can actually tell. We just have this stuff out here. What makes this zero? Well, the only number that works there is zero. What makes this zero? Well, that would be a positive 5. And what makes this zero? Well, that would be a negative 4. So those should be my solutions. Well, let's set these three things equal to zero and actually check. So I'm going to break them apart here, set them all equal to zero. Well, to get this guy just to be x, I take the square root of both sides. Well, the square root of zero is zero. Here I have to add 5 to both sides, and we get 5. Here I have to subtract 4 to both sides, so we get negative 4. Oops, negative 4. So, indeed, the three solutions I thought they would be just by looking at them are the solutions I'm actually going to work with. So we've found our solutions, and notice there's three solutions, which is kind of odd, because we might have expected there would be four solutions. You're probably thinking, Miss Warner, you said that there were always going to be as however many your highest exponent is, or your degree of your equation. Well, there are essentially four solutions. What happened over here was we had x squared being 0. So essentially, we square rooted it and got 0. And that means both of these solutions, since there's a 2 here, are 0. So what this is called is a double root. Okay? And when you get a double root, it's essentially 0 and 0, because you'd think plus minus 0 when we square root, but plus or minus 0 doesn't do anything. So we essentially have 2 zeros, which gives us a double root. Okay, so this is an odd thing that happens, but it does happen sometimes. There really are 4 solutions, but since we have that double root, it looks like the 2 zeros that we have is actually 1. Alrighty, so please join me in the next video for the last 2 examples.